Everyone, I'm Will, and today I'm going to show you how to identify Willowleaf wild lettuce. But before that, remember to like, subscribe, and comment down below, and don't forget to press that notification bell down below. Right here in between some wild black cherry, some lilac, and goldenrod, if you come in close, you can see some Willowleaf wild lettuce. To know that you have a wild lettuce, if you look on the top side, it will have like a green color, determined on what species you're looking at, but always on the bottom side will have a grayish hue versus the top does not. Now when you look at the structure of this wild lettuce, it will have like a purple stalk going down, nice thick and rustic strong stalk to hold it up. This plant, like all lettuce, can grow about like 3 to 6, maybe even 8 feet tall. One major characteristic of identifying this is the shape of the leaves, but not all of the leaves on this lettuce is going to be the same shape. Like up at the younger leaves towards the top are going to be very narrow and thin. The leaves are going to be about a half an inch to an inch in width and about 8 to 14 inches in length. Now when you look at the older leaves are going to be more serrated. They're going to have points on the side, and these points are going to be a good characteristic of knowing that there's two different varieties of shapes of the leaves. There's actually 4 different shapes of these leaves. So you can have the points, but only 2 of the points on the narrow part of the leaves, or more of a rounder of a leaf towards the base, like the lower one. Now with the lower leaves are going to be about 3/4 to an inch and a half in width and about 10 inches in length. Now the base will be a light green to purple of the trunk and base of this plant. It is going to be about a half an inch in width. Now when you look at the base of the lettuce plant, you are going to see some of the leaves from the basil rosette still left over. Now the leaves of those, if you look closely, a good indicator for all lettuce, they'll have a purple stem in the center. The center of the leaf is going to be purple, like a violet purple. Now the basil rosette leaves that are left over, look at the shape of them. There's the points are side to side, they're opposite of each other. And if you look at the leaves that are higher up, hence these ones, they're not opposite of each other. They're more like alternate. Now look very close to where the leaf attaches to the stalk. Now, right here, if you can see, there's little tiny like spurs that come off on the ends. Let's break one leaf off. Now you wanna like just break right at the base and pull right up. And there's those little points coming right off the end of them. Now here's the 3 different leaf structures of the wild lettuce. There can be 4 different leaf structures. Now, with the shapes of each of them, look at how they're actually formed. And right here is where you can see the point. There is only this one species of wild lettuce that has these. Now if you can see, like all lettuce, lettuce has latex. So the white stuff right here on the leaf, that is latex. Now if you have a latex, if you're allergic to latex, I recommend not using this as a pain relief medicine. If you want any wild lettuce products, go down in the description below, click the Amazon links to get yourself some wild lettuce products like capsules, teas, tinctures, extracts. You can go and get those clicking down in the description below. Now right here is another one that's not covered in all the plant matter, but this is a smaller one. This is half the size of the other one. And this one's also in the shade a bit. Like they're both in the shade, but they are sun-loving plants. So you mostly find lettuce kind of on the edges of like fields or on the side of gardens or in gardens. Now, when this goes to flower, it will have small yellow flower. Now, let's find out what this tastes like. Now, let's see if this is very bitter or can be used as a tabletop salad green. Kind of rustic, kind of texture. Ooh, really bitter. Not like extreme bitter, like a prickly wild lettuce flowers. Like the prickly wild lettuce flowers, the green part of the sepals. It's not as bitter as that, but it's still bitter and not as good for using as a salad green to use or cooking. It's more of, it's starting to taste like more of the strength for medicine. So, I recommend using it for like the medicine of extracting all the painkillers out of that. And that's how you identify Willowleaf wild lettuce. If you want to see more, go down in the description below, click the link to my channel, or press the round subscribe button to help me out to get to 1,000 subscribers. And next time, remember to get outside, get fresh air, and have fun. See ya.